Itu hari saya datang sini, saya jumpa saya abang. Tapi kawan bagi tahu Yubi abang sudah hantar hospital. Ambillah hantar di hospital. Saya tak tahu apa macam apa hat itu. Tapi saya ingat accident saja. Saya tak ingat dia bagi orang pukul. Saya pergi hospital cari, dia IC tak ada, nama tak ada. Hospital taruh nama orang Cina lah ya, dia tak ada nama. Belakang saya cari isi UKM, tak ada. Saya pergi General Hospital cari pun tak ada juga. Esok saya datang lagi, esok baru dia masuk ward. Pertama dia masuk kecemasan, bahaya. Tak ada nafas. Langsung tak ada nafas. Tak ada nafas. Esok saya datang lagi hospital. Dia hantar ward 18. Saya jumpa. Itu kali dia sudah ICU. Tak nafas, langsung tak nafas. Saya tanya dokter. Tengok dia biar nasib lah. 6 hari.
Pun mai koma
ya, koma. 6 hari. Doktor cakap mau tunggu dia report. Belum tahu macam mana. Saya tunggu 6 hari, 5 hari. Pun tak ada. Tak ada apa macam dia tak hidup lah.
Masih koma lah.
Masih
selepas
koma
dia lah. Dia meninggal, adakah polis hingga sekarang beritahu you apakah sebab you punya adik meninggal dunia? Mati. Ayo Tony Kong ini yang King Kong.
Mau. Langsung tak ada jawab. Saya ada tanya, langsung tak ada jawab.
Polis langsung tak ada jawab.
Informing me of the decision, why the police decided to charge the assailant or the with the family would prefer him to be called murderer. Why only charge under the section 324 penal code? Because it seems that it was only causing hurt, but what caused his death actually? So Ku Ching Wah say, according to the report by after postmortem. The doctors, the pathologist observation is that he was the cause of his death was not due to injury but inflammation of his lungs. Now this is of course causing very serious concern among us, not only the family members, because he was assaulted with great force and with deadly stick, which could have killed him on the spot. And in fact, he was after assaulted by the man. He was in coma, and he was admitted to hospital. And for 6 days in the ICU, he was in coma until his final breath. So I think we demand more how do you like to suggest another postmortem? Because the police, he said the police can't do very much because they decided to charge the assailant on the under 324 because that was the report by the doctor.
The assailant was charged under 324 of the Penal Code, voluntarily causing hurt by a dangerous weapon. Dia sudah charged di mahkamah. Dan bila saya tanya IO mahkamah mana tarikh bila, dia engang bagi tahu. Dia IO hanya kata dia akan bagi tahu keluarga si mati aja. Keluarga hanya diberitahu di charge under di bawah 324. full stop. Yang lain dia tak bagi tahu. Polis tambah bagi tahu saya. Kemungkinan besar bila di charge, kalau dia ada duit dia akan jamin jamin keluar itu. 324 maksimum hukum 3 tahun dipenjarakan atau rotan atau denda atau dua daripada dia. Jadi keluarga si Manti dia dinasihati oleh peguam DAP, dia rasa patut itu orang disiasat dan dituduh di bawah 304 kanun keseksaan itu homicide, maksimum penjara 10 tahun atau dengan denda atau dua sekalinya. Jadi ini wakil peguam daripada DAP yang akan bantu itu keluarga si Manti.
The prosecution can always amend the charge to section 304. You know, when the investigation paper has been reclassified, the prosecution can always amend the charge. They can amend the charge at any time. Especially given the scenario here that the victim was assaulted, and because of the assault, he was in coma for 6 days.
Then he died.
And it follows the death. But the police must first reclassify the IP first. They have to reclassify the IP. Upon the reclassification, then the prosecution will review the charge and amend the charge. So because we are talking about a life that has been lost, the injury has caused death.